guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to paint this amazing snowman and we're going to use salt for the background. Timestamps and a full list of materials are in the description below. Let's start with the background. I did not tape this down because I want all the craziness of the bulging paper. When I wet in the paper, it's going to bulge and it's going to make it easier for me to create a really crazy background with those really undefined patterns. First, I'm adding a lot of water to the paper and I let it sink in for a second. I'm leaving a little gap between the water and the line drawing, just to make it easier for me later on to create straight lines. Next, I load a brush with blue color and I start painting around the snowman. I start to close that gap between the line drawing and the water. I'm working in sections here and I do not let any area of the background dry out while I'm painting. So when I see an area is getting a little bit dry, I just add more water or pigment to it. It just allows me a longer time to work on it and add more pigment. This background should have a large contrast, which means there are areas that have barely any pigment and areas that have a lot of pigment. Just to create a larger contrast towards the snowman, I'm making sure to add a lot of pigment in those areas that are next to the snowman. Sometimes puddles are forming with a lot of pigment or a lot of water in them. And it's really up to you if you want those puddles or if you want to redistribute the pigment a little bit. I think it's easier to move the pigment around a bit to have an evenly wet surface. I have some salt in my hand and I evenly distribute it around the painting. Once the salt is on the page, I try not to move it. It will cause streaks on the page and I try to make snowflakes here, so streaks don't really work. While this is drying, the salt will soak up the watercolor and this will leave a really interesting pattern on the background. This took a long time to dry, but once it is dry, I can just rub the salt off the page. Let's turn our attention to the snowman. The head is a good place to start. I work in layers here. So first I'm using a light wash of black to color in some parts of the head, and after it's dried I can always go back in with more pigmented layers and darken it up. This makes it easier to create some shaded areas in the head and create a color gradient. The head will just look more interesting if it has different grades of transparency. The head is colored in one section at a time to make it easier to create those gradients in transparency. Coloring in the entire head in one go would just look flat and boring. There are three different methods I can use to create highlights. The first method is just to paint around the highlight, leaving it white. The second method is to color in the entire area and then soak up some of the pigment with a moist brush. The third method is to color in the entire area with a light wash, let it dry completely, and then color in that area again with a darker wash and just leave that one spot blank where you want the highlight to be. The scarf is painted in sections as well for the same reasons. I color in the entire part of the scarf with a light red wash and then I'm dropping in some more colors at the bottom area. I can also lift some colors at the top area where the light meets the scarf to create a highlight. If the scarf has the perfect amount of wetness to it, the color will bleed upwards and it will create a gradient. Let's color in the nose with yellow first and let it dry before adding the orange, because this will make the orange glow. After 2 minutes of drying time, the scarf is dry enough to not cause any bleeding when I color in the other parts of the scarf. So I just go ahead and do that. I also try to create some gradients there. If the top part of the scarf is not dry enough yet, you can always leave a tiny line between the different sections so that you do not risk any bleeding. Getting the facial features in the right positions is really important with a snowman. That's why I painted them in with a pencil first. I tried to paint in coal pieces as mouth first, but that just didn't look good, so I connected the dots and made it one line. And don't forget the coal buttons. And by the way, the background came out so busy that I decided against giving it the arms that you saw in the line drawing earlier. The head is dry enough for another layer of black pigment. I leave out some areas that I do not want to paint another layer on, and I just paint the shaded areas and the areas that should be really dark. I could not yet add another layer to that one part of the head because the black paint from the first layer was simply not dry enough yet. Let's build up the layer on the nose. I'm adding some orange pigment to the shaded area of the nose, and I will be adding another layer later on. Let's also add some more of the red pigment to the shaded areas in the scarf. Each layer of pigment makes the color more vibrant, and the snowman will pop off the page even more. If your snowman looks dull, just try adding another layer of pigments. Adding too many small details can easily make it look crowded. The eye doesn't know what to look at first, and those details are too small to actually understand them from a distance without observing it closer. Now, this part of the head is dry enough for the next layer of pigment. Here, I'm adding concentrated watercolor to the shaded area of the head. I then clean off my brush and dab it on a paper towel to dry it off. The damp brush is then used to create a soft gradient. The watercolor is too dry to freely flow into the area, which I just added some moisture to, which makes it easy to control. And I can always soak up some pigment with my dried brush if something does go wrong. A damp brush is the easiest way to create soft edges. The secret of this painting is truly the contrast. The color I chose contrast because they lay on opposite sides of the color wheel. When you put them next to each other, each color looks even stronger. It makes the contrast even bigger. There is a contrast in structure, and also the color gradient makes a big difference. As a conclusion, don't be afraid to use really strong colors. Let's talk about creating the loose style shadows that you see on the snowman. It's easy if you just have the right technique. This shadow will be painted in multiple layers, and every layer will have a little bit more dark pigment added to it. Each shadow will have two or three layers. I will be adding the next layer in the drying pigment, so the previous layer is not completely dry yet when I add the next layer. Each time when I add a new layer of shadow, that new shadow is smaller than the previous one, which means it does not cover as much of a white area as the previous layer did, and therefore the center where I add the shadow will be darker than the previous layer. These frizzled outer edges are created by having an almost dry brush, so there's not a lot of watercolor in my brush. The snowman is facing the light source, so the light source is on the right side. The shadows will therefore be on the left side. I realize that the shadow on the bottom is contradicting it, but hey, it's a loose painting, so what? Once the shadows are dry, which only takes 2 or 3 minutes because it's such a light layer, I will be adding a line around the snowman, around every single ball, every single segment of the snowman, just to show that they are different segments. I will also be adding this outline to the scarf, just to give it the same style as the snowman's body. And there we have it, a snowman using salt for the background. Thank you so much for watching my video. I hope you liked it. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, leave me a comment, let me know what you want me to paint next, and I will see you soon with another video.